Hi, I'm Magic Cyborg and I'm a nerd who makes stuff. As someone who is quite experienced with Blender and is currently learning Godot, there's something that has been bugging me. If you've been watching Blender tutorials, then you might have heard of the term topology. Topology, in layman's terms, is the arrangement of vertices, edges, and faces that make up a 3D mesh. Now, there are countless tutorials that describe what makes good topology. And from what I found, good topology consists of the following traits. 1. Every single face is in the shape of a square or rectangle, also known as a quad. 2. The model has good edge flow, meaning the polygon should be able to loop around the mesh without any weird misdirection. 3. The model doesn't consist of any triangles or n-gons. Okay, well, technically triangles are okay in some cases, but n-gons are a big no-no. Avoid them at all costs. Now this is cool and all, but what exactly are the benefits of good topology? Well, there's actually quite a lot of them. It makes subdividing easier, it makes UV unwrapping easier, it makes texture painting easier, it pretty much makes your whole life easier. Also, it just looks prettier. So with all of this in mind, I would like to turn your attention to video game models, because they say screw all of that, I'm doing what I want. Look, I know I said triangles are okay in some cases, but this is just overkill. And yes, this is the official Mario model from Super Mario Odyssey. It's not just Mario either. Video game models of all kinds use this weird triangular topology. Why? Well, the first possible answer that came to mind was optimization. Optimization is essentially the process of reducing a video game's demands from the CPU or GPU. Doing this will make the game run smoothly at a consistent frame rate. Without optimization, games would run like this. So maybe that's what these triangles are for, to make it easier for the computer to render so the game has better performance. And upon doing research, that's actually what the answer is. Games just run better when models look like this. So that's it. Video over, right? Well, not so fast. Pardon me for sounding skeptical, but I can't help but ask how. Let me show you where I'm coming from. Blender has this handy feature where you can easily turn your quads into triangles. Select all of your geometry, then go to Face, Triangulate Faces, and the shortcut for this is Ctrl T. And boom, we have a video game model. So what Triangulate Faces actually does is just cut faces in half diagonally. And if we delete these diagonal lines on the Mario model, we could see quads. So it's likely that the 3D artists at Nintendo have used a similar technique. But here's the thing though, by turning our quads into triangles, we have increased the amount of edges and the amount of faces, according to Blender statistics. Remember, this is all about performance, and models with a higher poly count can cause a video game to lag. So if triangulating our mesh leads to a higher poly count, and higher poly count leads to bad performance, why are we using triangles at all? Well, there's something that we haven't yet considered. While the edges and faces have increased, the amount of vertices have remained exactly the same. Why is this important? Well, in order to render 3D models, our machines do a lot of math under the hood, calculating the position of each individual vertex in 3D space. That might seem like a daunting task, but these math problems are actually measured in the billions, so I think we're safe there. But what difference do triangles make? Well, the answer is that triangles are easier for the computer to calculate. No matter where you move the vertices, the triangle will always have a flat surface. You think the same applies to quads, but just by moving the corner of a quad, things can become complicated. I'm not sure if this is the only reason that triangles are easier to calculate, but I couldn't exactly find any more specific answers. But all of this goes to show how much developers value optimization. Or at least most of them do. But even if it's just to reduce the complexity of math problems that the computer can already do in the billions, artists will do anything to stretch out some space for creative freedom. And I guess that leads us to the end of this silly nerdy video. If you have any more questions about this, feel free to ask them down in the comments. I'm not exactly an expert, so I'm not sure if I'll be able to answer all of them. After all, I am still learning myself, but I'll try my best. Also, I wanted to give a shout out to the Models Resource for those official game models, and to Blender for their human-based meshes demo file, which I was able to use as an example for this video. What, did you think I made this model myself? Oh, please. Also, I wanted to thank Vox for making both an article and video on the topic of these triangles, for this acted as my main source for this video. Anyway, that's all for me. Thank you so much for watching, and have an amazing day.